the 501, baby.
Uh-huh.
You know how we get down on the WuPig Podcast. Woo. Shout out OD, shout out G-Homes, it's the bad.
Big Sexy.
Woo, yeah, yeah. Woo, yeah, yeah. Woo.
Welcome to the WuPig Podcast, coming to you live from the Insurance Max Studios, where we talking about everything Arkansas Razorback football and basketball every Monday, Thursday, and Saturday. Man, check out the website, thewupig.com. I want you to experience peace of mind with Insurance Max, though. That's your one-stop solution for home, auto, and commercial insurance statewide. Man, don't wait. Call them today for a free no-obligation quote. Secure your future with Insurance Max, where protection meets affordability. Dial now, safeguard what matters. 870-534-2823. Holler at my guy Wes and Caleb over there. They're gonna take good care of you. And the WuPig Podcast, man, we stream it on all major platforms: Facebook, YouTube, Twitter, and Twitch. You can catch us on all those. Make sure you subscribe to us though on every last one of them. Don't forget to do that. And if you enjoy audio only, you can catch us everywhere, Apple Podcasts. We really rock with Spotify. You already know. Go run that up for your boys. You can switch between audio and video while you're at work. Ain't nobody going to know. And holler at our guys, 3M Electric, if you need some electrical work done in Northwest Arkansas. They're your trusted commercial and residential contractor. As an SDV OSB, they're dependable and reliable with no job too big or small. When it comes to your electrical needs, contact 3M Electric, 479-408-9865. Let them know you heard it on the WuPig Podcast. And you already know who I got in the building.
Yo, it's your boy G Holmes in the building, a.k.a. Big Sexy. Somebody out there holler for your boy.
Oh my God.
What it do, O.D.?
Hey man, you know what I don't know if it's me, I don't know if it's you, but you sound like you Milli Vanilli right now. Girl, you know it's true. You lip syncing out here.
What you
like
talking
you
about?
Like you in a kung fu movie or something.
Hey man. Hey man, that ain't my fault, sucker, man. I don't know. That's your internet. You the one running the stream, man.
Hey, I got that Google Fiber, baby. You know it's rolling over here.
Hey,
man.
Bro. Hey man, I don't know what to tell you, dog. I don't know what to tell you.
And we got the bad little brother looking like Roscoe off of Martin.
Yeah.
You gonna sell my candy, Gina? You gonna sell my candy?
What it do, gang? What's See, up with y'all, man?
Everybody saying the sound off, man. The sound is off. What's up?
Hey, it's I'm delayed. With 3M Electric. I don't know about y'all.
Hey, man.
Oh, no. I knew something was off, man. I'm like, something ain't right, man.
What you mean? Like it ain't synced up?
Yeah, I felt it was off, but man,
hold on.
I'm
then.
Sorry,
hold
guys.
On.
I'm gonna have to. Hopefully, it works itself out. I don't think it's even G. It may
Is
just
it
be
both
all of
us
right now. I don't know. Y'all, let us know what the sound like. I may be able to fix it on the fly. There we go. We got G back in the building.
Now, but how man, about that?
Let me see. Keep talking.
Yo, check your boy out. I don't know.
You straight.
Well then.
If somebody said it's fixed, it's good now. All right, we in the building.
Okay. That's what's
that
up.
Was G is on that Boost Mobile internet. They was dragging
kids
us down.
Cool, bro. But anybody still what you talking about?
Hey. Mm-hmm. Hey, man, the Hogs will find a way to lose. Find
Super
a way.
Try it.
We are 15 points, man. And I'm sitting there, I'm like, 15. Man, it's too good to be true, man. It's too good to be
true. Too good to be true.
Then We up 3 points.
Dang.
My boy going to the rack. He drop it off to Twinkle Toes. Twinkle Toes goes up for the dunk. And he blew the bunny like Robert Hill.
Yeah.
Bruh.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And it was all down here. We lost. What the deal, man? What the stats looking like, man? What, talk to me, G.
Bruh. Hey, man, you gonna get that super chat out the way, man, before I get into this and start cooking.
Well, let me bring up, man. Shout out to my guy, Big Man Ross, in the building. He says, let's get the super chat started. Yeah,
let's
boy.
Go. Let's bang, get bang, him. Bang, let's bang. Get him. Man. Bro, yeah. I'm almost so disappointed in these. I mean, okay, so let's just run it down right quick, man. We started Brazil, Lawson, Ellis, Mark, and Battle. That's been the starting, you know, for the last, you know, few games. So Brazil, he played a lot of minutes this time. He played 30 minutes. I think that's the most he's played in the last, since he came back. He was 6 of 12 from the field. He took three threes and missed them all. Never got to the free throw line with 6 rebounds, 1 steal, 2 blocks, 2 turnovers. He had 12 points. Lawson, 15 minutes. This dude right here, hey man, the long arm on the law is not that good, man. 1 of 2 from the field. Ofa, he got 6 rebounds, 1 steal, 2 blocks, 2 points. I said that. 2 points.
Super trash.
L. Ellis, he played the whole game, man. He played 40 minutes, 5 of 11 from the field, 0 of 1 from the 3-point, 1 of 2 from the line. He had 4 rebounds, 3 assists, 1 steal, 2 turnovers for 11 points. Mark played 30 minutes, 3 of 10. That dude is struggling, bro. Big shot Mark, he's struggling right now, man. He was 3 of 10 from the field, 1 of 3 from 3. He made all his free throws, 6 of 6. He brought 3 rebounds, 1 assist, 1 steal, 1 turnover for 13 points. Battle. Man, that dude been balling, man. I can't even hold him, but he putting up some shots. But he getting most of his points from the line. He was 5 of 16 from the field. That's terrible. 1 of 6 from the from 3. That's also terrible. But he was 11 of 11 from the free throw line. 7 rebounds, 1 assist, 1 steal, 1 block. 6 turnovers.
Super trash.
6 turnovers for 22 points. Then the bench, Twinkle Toes. He was 7 to 10. He pretty consistent. He was 7 to 10 or 7 to 9 from the field. He didn't take a 3-pointer, of course. 4 of 6 from the free throw line. He had 5 rebounds, 1 assist, 4 blocks, 4 turnovers. We got to tighten that up. Well, it don't matter. It's over with now. 18 points. Davenport, 3 of 4 from the field, 2 of 3 from 3, 2 rebounds, 1 assist, 8 points. Then I am so glad this season is over with, man. So glad this season is over with. Your boy, he played 30 minutes off the bench. 30 minutes. He was 0 for everything. You heard what I said. 0 for everything. 2 of 2 from the from the free throw line. That's the only points he got. 3 rebounds, 2 assists, 1 steal for 2 points. I'm sorry. I don't care
Super trash.
What y'all got to say. I'm so glad that. Whoa, I hope he don't come back next year. That's the stat rundown. Hogs find a way to lose in overtime after being up double digits in the second half. Y'all tell me. They just don't know how to win.
Allergic to it. It's like it's just not in our DNA this season. I don't know what it is. And, you know, the scariest part about this loss, you know, I didn't even expect to win, but the scariest part about this loss is they did so many things right. And it was the first time that I saw a lot of stuff. Like who y'all want to start with first? Let's start with Brazil. Since when did Brazil start driving the ball in? Since when did Brazil start? I'm like, wait, it almost made me feel like we had a chance. I'm like, this is what we've been asking for all season. What is this? Where is this coming from? And then you got Davenport. I mean, he didn't do amazing. He had his regular good hustle, but he was hitting shots the last couple games. He had, what, two decent shots this game? And then, you know, Sweet Thing come with the air balls. So we ain't even going to spend too much time on him. But yeah, in my opinion, the biggest thing that hurt me this game, Battle needs some help, Mark. I don't know if Tremont Mark used up all of his baller minutes earlier in the season, but these last couple games been so hit or miss for him. And I just feel like they can't
play together, man. I've been telling y'all that. They both are ball-dominant players. If they don't have the ball, they can't play. They got to have the ball.
OD said that not long ago. They both ain't going to get off in the same game.
Nope, it's one or the other.
If we can make that happen, this would be the team that would be the team that we thought we was gonna see this year. You see so many sparks and flashes, and then it's just like it's never together. Yeah. Never.
That would call for a coach who knows how to draw up a play. Bottom line. Okay, I'm gonna go. I know what you're gonna talk about. I'm gonna go to the end of the game, right?
Yep. Out of the timeout.
End of the game is tied up. It's tied up. 73-73. I think that was the score. 73-74, whatever it was. Timeout. We got 28 seconds on the clock. He comes out of a timeout and does ISO. No screen, no nothing. Just straight ISO. What kind of mess is this, bro? How could you not have a play? I don't understand. Any basketball coach I've ever seen out of a timeout got a play that they gonna score, that they about to score. They know what they gonna run. We out there running ISO basketball like we playing under the bridge at War Memorial. We gonna give the ball to Los. Los got him. Get the ball to Los.
Yeah, he got him.
He got him.
Yeah, we got a mismatch.
or
that was bad. You know what that was. Give him Go ahead.
I was gonna say, or at least give him some direction. If Battle is 11 of 11 from the free throw line, and we in our last drive to win the game, at least take it in and possibly get a foul. To pull a shot is ridiculous. It's crazy. What did you tell him in the huddle?
Yeah. Hey, I want you to act like you Dame Dillard. You Dame Dillard. Just pull up. Just pull up and wave bye-bye. Bruh, you is not Dame.
Yeah, you're not that guy.
Battle waves off the screen. I don't know if that was the play that was drawn up, but he waves off the screen and does the Dame Dillard step to the side, shoot the three, barely hit the rim.
Yeah.
Bruh, I want to know what the play was.
Yeah.
What was the play?
It wasn't no play. I don't know if it was a busted play or I don't know, but he really thought he'd been cooking. He was like, you know what? I finna make a name for myself. Yeah, you made a name for yourself. Yeah, you definitely made a name for yourself.
Super like, trash.
This win was so important. This win was so important. Like, this, bro, this why win would
be below 500.
Let me tell you why. Below 500. Let me explain why. It's important because what have everybody been saying as far as the bright spot at the end of the season? What if we run the tourney? What if we get an attorney and this win would have gave us some momentum to where we've been like, you know what? Maybe we might do something in the tournament. Like this game was the last piece of confidence that this team could have put together. And I think dropping the ball on this one it wasn't a good look.
Man, shout out to Mr. and Mrs. Shane Nellums, man. They wanted us to give them a shout out. April Nellums, we want to give you a shout out. Thanks for watching us and hanging out with the boys tonight on the WuPig Podcast.
Yes, sir.
I got a super chat read. WuPig Honcho in the building. Thank you for supporting the channel. He says, shout out to them, to the members. Man, you show right, man. Shout the members out, man. I need to shout my members out. I ain't shouted y'all out in a minute. Let's get to it. Let me run that. I used to have it, but I don't remember which one it was. I'm going to run y'all back in a minute. I'm going to have y'all rolling across the bottom. What was you saying, DJ, before I cut you off? You muted, bro.
My bad. But what I was saying was just this win was the confidence we needed for any type of postseason, anything. I'm back to no hope now. Like, there was points in this game where I seen so much. I'm like, hold on, Brazil doing what? Wait, Davenport finally hit something? Like, I'm looking like, okay, I think this team gonna do a little something in the tournament. But after that loss now, I'm like, I have no hope. Like, I think we're going to lose the first game, no matter who it is.
This is what I feel like. I feel like we did enough in that game to win. We did enough to – even though the stat lines is, you know, kind of suspect or whatever, but we did enough to win, bro. We were – and I hate to keep saying this, man. We were out-coached again. We were out-coached. Whenever you have that much of a lead, when you see the lead slipping, you got to call the right timeouts. You got to get your guys into the right sets. You know what I'm saying? Defensively. They didn't never change the defense. Did they ever change that? No.
Not that I seen.
I didn't see them change the defense. Clearly this man, defense, hey, man, they coming back. I don't know if Arkansas knows how to run a matchup zone or anything like that. You gonna let them shooters just get off like that? You feel me?
Hey, man.
So
that three he hit was so cold too. Over, step back, clink, tie game.
I just want y'all to. I want you to go with me for a second when it comes to Musselman and his stats, bro. In the last 2 years. Musselman is 14-22 in the SEC with five NBA players. Five.
Wait, 14 and what?
14-22.
Ain't no way. Let me. Hey, ain't no way.
Them facts. 14-22, bro. With five NBA players. Four last year and Brazil this year. Maybe even Mark. Maybe. You got five NBA players, and you mean to tell me all you got is 14 wins to show for it?
Wow.
I'm just saying, guys, if we lose Musselman, I ain't going to cry. That's all I'm saying. I ain't crying.
Who phone is that dingy?
Bro, that's Kingy Bingy over here.
Mutual phone. He talking about you.
No, it's my computer. Go ahead, y'all. I'm gonna do that while y'all y'all thoughts on that.
Man, I'm telling you, that's for me. I think that's what it is. It's just Musselman. Sometimes he gets out coached, and I'm saying like he doesn't make the in-game adjustments like most of your coaches do. So, but to have that caliber of player and then still, you know, not have a better record than that. I mean, even though they done got deep in the tournament. But
yeah,
they struggle. I mean, I can't hold them on that. But I don't know.
I guess getting the wins in the tournament is ultimately what matters. We want to see them wins in the tournament, but this year we ain't even going to make the tournament, which leads me to my next question. Do you feel like these Hawks dangerous enough to make a run in the SEC tournament?
Mm-mm.
Do you feel like we dangerous? Not that we going to win. Do you think we can make some noise?
Hey, nah. I'm going to say it like this. I'm going to say it like
funny,
this.
Man.
We dangerous if you mean we gonna make it a close game for everybody just to lose at the end. If that's dangerous, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, no.
No. Y'all say no?
Nah, we ain't gonna make no noise.
None.
Nah.
Bruh. Ill Will says ULR making it to the NCAA tournament this year in Arkansas? Is nasty.
I don't know,
work.
Bro. That's what Bing was talking about. He said they in trouble in that championship game. They down five with a minute left.
Who? Euler?
Euler.
Ah. Well.
So they may not be making the tournament because in order for them to get in, they got to win this tournament.
They got to win. You know, they ain't getting no at-large. Who they playing?
Exactly. So they got, I don't even know. That's what, you know, that's what Bingy was talking about when he was texting.
Okay. You know, I wasn't reading the text. So they lost. We feel like they ain't going to make no noise in the tournament, man. I feel like we dangerous. I feel like the team we saw today, if they can just tweak a few little things, and let me not put it, I don't like to give anybody a pass, and I pretty much don't give them anybody a pass, man, but the refs, bro, man, bro, they was super trash. They was, man, calling everything on us.
Man, what you expect? First off, what you expect? That's home cooking. Last game of the year, it's home cooking. And I'm no longer going to rely on the refs, to bail us out, bro. I mean, man, I'm no longer going to rely on that, because clearly that ain't happening. The refs ain't like giving us the benefit of the doubts, even at home. So you're gonna have to outplay these cats.
And I'm gonna say this, man. I don't think the refs are the reason we lost this game. I mean, a lot of people say that. It was some points in the game where they was getting it on Alabama. We actually was getting helped by the refs at certain points too in the game. I'm gonna keep it a buck. It was certain points in the game where they was like, you know what, we just gonna let them play. And it was a couple of them. I'm like, oh, okay. And then they kind of turned that whistle back on towards the end. So it was weird. Man, I don't know.
I'm with BKA70. He said the refs was cooking on the hibachi grill, man. What you talking about, man? They was
out there open flame.
Did y'all see how mad Bama coach was towards the end of the game? Because we was all right for a little minute. They just got us towards the end. But, you know, that's how refs are. They get hot and cold, so. I'm not going to put it on the
that
refs.
Was a clear foul on Twinkle Toes' dunk. That was a clear foul.
Oh, yeah. I give you that.
Yeah.
I give you that.
Yeah.
And they didn't call that. So, bruh. But, man, we going to move on to our next topic that we want to get into, man. Let me read my super chats before I do that. I got two of them. Jeremiah, man, thank you for supporting the channel, man, as always. He says, the game was supposed to be sealed with that dunk with Mitchell. Yep. Glad this season is over. This game explains our whole season. We can't finish games.
We find a way to lose.
Yep. Absolutely. Always finding a way to lose. Shout out Lil Rock 2517, man. He always supporting the channel. Now, topic in hand, man. We lost the coach. Jimmy Smith leaves the University of Arkansas to go to TCU. Who does that? That's like saying, you know what? I'm going to leave this $25 an hour job that I got at Verizon to go make $10 an hour at Cricket.
He ain't go to UAPB.
TCU, bro. They've been in the big one more. I mean, they more recent than we have.
What, a couple years ago?
2 years ago. Yeah.
That's one. Yeah, you're right. They've been around. They got that. We didn't. But
they
still
got a lot of like.
Why?
It's more like I'm a quit this job at Chick-fil-A. And I'm going to take my talents to Wendy's. You know what I'm saying? Neither one of them was great, but at least my boy is over here. You feel me?
Yeah.
I want everybody in the comments to tell me why you think Jimmy Smith left the University of Arkansas.
I want everybody in my like button.
Man, you kind of, your audio was kind of jacked up right there.
What?
It was kind of like underwater.
Say it again, G.
Yo, I want everybody in the comments to hit the like button. Underwater.
Yeah, no, that was good.
Oh, okay.
So Marcus Mitchell says,
y'all do that.
Job security. Matt says Jimmy ain't look good without Bryles.
Mm.
Nima says Jimmy left because he couldn't pick up Petrino's system. He need an RPO offense where his backs don't need to pick up a blitz.
Mm. Wow. There were some low spots. There were some. But the thing about it is, okay, so yes, we had on paper a great running back room. But we watched several games where DeBinion, when I tell you whiffing blocks, like my man said, he wasn't even trying to make some blocks. When the man is blitzing off of the corner, and that is your responsibility to catch the block coming from, you know, your side of the ball where you're lined up on the left hand of the quarterback and the blitz comes from that way, that's your man. That's your guy. And you whiff that block. Now, I mean, don't even whiff it. I'm thinking he's still down like this. You know what I'm saying? He just ran by him. So there were a lot of things in that running back room that were not right last year. So are we really disappointed? They running backs, bro. I'm more disappointed in his recruiting. Now, he could recruit a good running back.
What?
But
I'm ready to argue.
All right. Well, I mean.
Now, before the argument starts about how good Jimmy was at recruiting, the word on the street is that Jimmy – we all know Jimmy was interviewing for that job at running backs coach at University of Georgia. We all know that.
Yeah.
Word on the street is that Jimmy got the job. They offered Jimmy the job.
Mm-mm.
But Sam Pittman hit him with the CB. He hit him with the CB. Nah, bruh. We can't let that happen. In your contract, you can't move to another SEC school without us saying it's cool.
And he said it ain't cool. He blocked it.
Now, this word on the street.
They call it baller blocking.
And Jimmy Smith was like, all right, cool. Bet that up. So come in Kendall Bryles, like
hit him on the line.
He is, and say, hey, man, come on over here. We got a spot for you. And as my boy Sam Jones says, Jimmy got sold. And he was like, I'm out of here.
Hey, Kendall Bryles came in there like a Suge Knight. If you don't want a coach, all in the videos. Come on over here to TCU. He came over there and got him.
But
so guess
like,
what?
This got to be a lesson, man. When people say, I want to leave, I want to go, don't try to hinder me from moving forward in my career, bro. I want to go. I'm ready to leave. Don't try to sit here and hold me back because you want me to coach these running backs. Because guess what? Mm-hmm. Now they probably gonna be like, hey, we out of here.
Yeah.
Some of them running backs, DeBinion,
hey, man.
He probably gonna be gone, but you know, whatever. I ain't tripping.
Bye.
Augustov, I'm tripping. I want to see him play for the Hawks. Tripping.
Yep.
And the guy we just got from Utah probably can't go nowhere because he just transferred, so he can't go nowhere.
That's great news.
Who else we got? We got old boy, big boy from Benton.
Braylon Russell.
We got him. Yeah. So we got the other guy we got from St. Louis. Hey, man.
Running back room still look good.
It look good until they leave, though.
Yeah, we don't know who about to dip with him. And that's a whole nother conversation that we got to get into, because who can we afford to lose? Well, I'm going to say this. We got three running backs, and as long as those three that we just named don't leave, we good. If we keep old guy from Utah, I don't know how I'm blanking on his name, Jaquindon Jackson. If we keep him, we keep Russell, and we keep Augustus, I don't care who leave. DeBean, you can go. Take him with you. Dominique Johnson, you can go. Your knee being, I'm sorry. I used
Is
to
he
be
still
a fan.
On the team?
Yes, he's still
Man,
on
he
the
been
team.
He been playing for the Hawks since Quinn Grovey was there. That boy been there for a long time. He been there forever, hey, man. Hey, Matt says, hey, man, they ain't no sponsor. We don't care about them. Hey, man,
that's your freezer, baby.
Matt said he can't blame Sam for doing that, though. I'm not about to leave Georgia, walk in, and take my coaches and possible players. A coach going to Georgia don't really hurt us. It just don't. Yeah. It don't Georgia's move the dominant one anyway. Way or the other. Exactly. They going to dominate one way or the other right now.
Yeah.
So,
Coaching is not what makes them, you know, dominant. They just on a good roll right now with their recruiting.
Yeah.
So I want to break this whole Jimmy Smith thing down. So, for the people who don't know what we're talking about, I'm going to repeat what OD just gave us. We got some insider news that the reason Jimmy Smith left, because let's keep it real. Any coach that was going to leave a university, this is not the time to do it. In spring ball, in the middle of position battles, people trying to make a name, this is not when coaches usually leave. So it has to be a serious reason or something behind the scenes to happen that we don't know about. So our insider hit up OD, hit up G, told him, hey, man, the reason Jimmy left is because when he was about to get that Georgia job, Pittman came in and vetoed that and was like, no, sir, not in the SEC. Nope. So I think first we got to talk about what type of coach Jimmy is.
But he let old boy go to Mississippi State.
What you mean? His boy.
Hey, what the difference is?
Kennedy.
Yeah.
Kennedy. Yeah.
He let him go.
But he was trash.
That's a good point.
He was trash.
He gonna get fired anyway. So he like, okay.
Hey, man, I'm gonna still keep on putting some food on your family table. It's up to you after this.
Bruh. Anyway, go ahead, DJ. I ain't mean to cut you off, man. I just had to say that.
That was a great point because I ain't even think about it like that, man.
Hey, shout out to the professor.
But what I was getting at was, is Jimmy a good coach or not? So let's look at his weaknesses first, because they kind of obvious, and then let's look at his strengths. So weakness, like G just said, he didn't develop nobody. Name a running back that got better under Jimmy Smith. I can't think of none. Pass blocking. I mean, you could blame last year on the O-line. Okay. But let's talk about rotations. How many times do we get on this show during the season? Like, why did we not see A.J. Green in this game? Why did we not see blah, blah, blah in this game? You mean to tell me that Pittman run the personnel in the running back room too? No, that was Jimmy Smith. His rotation sucked last year. It was like Musselman. We like, why is Pinion on the bench? So I think those were his weaknesses, rotations and development. But let's talk about his strengths. He is a former Georgia high school coaching legend. A lot of people don't know that. If you look at Arkansas's recruits, we have never had so many recruits, especially high-star recruits, coming out of Georgia till Jimmy got here. Jimmy was probably our best recruiter on our coaching staff. And another weird little fact that I want y'all to think about. Did y'all know that Jimmy Smith and what's his name? Scott Foster, whoever our special teams coach is, they were the last two coaches from Pittman's original coaching tree when he came to Arkansas. After Jimmy's gone, Scott Found, that's his name. He is the only coach left that came here with Pittman. That's something crazy to think about.
Hey, Matt, Cody Kennedy was never fired. He was not fired.
Nah, he wasn't fired. Ooh, that's
there's the article right there. He left.
Oh, yeah. Oh, I was going to say, what is that?
Yeah, that's the article. I don't know if they can highlight it, but he was not fired.
Man, you know what time it is. It's time to open up the hog pen, man.
It's already open. Before we bring up everybody in the chat who want to come up and kick it with us and talk about our topics for the night, Deezy, man, we got to shout the sponsors out, man.
Yes, sir. So you already know we got to show major love to our guys over at Insurance Max. Experience a peace of mind with Insurance Max, your one-stop solution for home, auto, and commercial insurance statewide. Don't wait. Call today for a free, no obligation quote. Secure your future with Insurance Max and protect what matters the most. Call those guys at 870-534-2823. And then you know we got to shout out 3M Electric. serving Northwest Arkansas. They're your trusted commercial and residential electric contractor. As an SDV OSB, they're dependable and reliable with no job too big or too small. So when it comes to your electrical needs, call 3M at 479-408-9865. Let them know you heard it on the best podcast in the land, baby. WuPig.
Yizzer, yizzer. Man, we got Box in the building. But before we bring Box on there, hey, I got something to say. If you are not subscribed to this channel, man, you guys help us out. Help us get to that 3,000 subscriber mark by the end of the month. That's the goal. We got 21 days to get there. 22 maybe. Help us out.
Yeah.
Tell a friend, tell We're a
trying
friend.
Trying to get to 3,000.
Subscribe to the WuPig Podcast. Help us get to that number, man. Box, what it do?
What's up, guys?
Man. What you think about that game today, Box, man? Tell us what you think.
Not sure. You would have lost a word.
You know what? You know what? I would look at the game. We was up. I like, damn.
Hey, hold on. Turn your game down. You super loud.
Your game way high.
What about now?
Still turn high. Down a little bit more.
All right. What about now?
All right, you better. Yeah.
All right, I was looking at the game today. I was like, man, I finna get on here and get these boys some props tonight.
And then what happened?
Hey, I like these guys finna mess up me in OD prediction. But I'm happy with it. I'm happy with it. I went and talked to this customer, came back. It was like, we was up by 3. I was like, oh, that's it. We're gonna lose. What's so sad is there ain't no way we should been up by much. We've been up under 10 minutes and lose this game. Mm-mm. And I heard somebody said on Tuss Ty podcast that he was satisfied with how hard we played.
That's terrible.
I don't care how hard we played. A loss is a loss.
Yeah.
And so I'm going to ask y'all a question. And I know this ain't for y'all, because I know y'all how y'all feel. Let's say we played hard all year for 31 games. We gave it our all. We played our arses off all year long for 31 games. But we lost every game by 1 point. Is y'all happy that we played hard? Playing hard don't mean nothing if you don't get no victories.
Yeah.
We played good today. I heard DC say that. We played good today. But we did something wrong to lose.
Mm-hmm. Facts.
So regardless how good that everybody said we played today, we still lost. At the end of the day, we got a losing record in my fifth season. I don't care how bad a coach you is, you don't go to Elite Eights like that, Sweet 16, and then all of a sudden your fifth year, when it's your team, audio team, and you got to lose a record. That's coaching.
It's recruiting as well.
That's coaching. Yeah. He recruited him. That's coaching.
Now, before we continue this conversation, I got to read my super chats. Box, while we working on that, turn your gain down to about 60%, man.
Man, you told me that already.
Hey, Jeremiah, man, thank you for supporting the channel, man. He said, bro, the running back coach mishandled A.J. Green playing time, and man. A.J. Green last season was our best running back. He should have got more rotation. That's why A.J. left. No lies detected.
Hey, I just said that.
Hey, we already said that.
Can I say something about the running back?
Yeah, what up?
Let me read my super chat, and then you can say what you want to say. We're going to come back. Hey, but thank you for supporting the channel. Ty Collins Sr. Hey, DeMelo and Young Lady hook up. He ain't been back on the podcast in a few.
I know, right?
And they hopped off. He in the comments. Melo, you
alive?
Yeah, they're going to Melo 501. He in here hollering.
Hey, just so y'all know, I seen Melo on Tuss podcast. I ain't seen that dude smile that much in a minute. So, wow. so he had to hit old girl. Look, he was smiling like crazy.
Hey man, he be in the bedroom making them pancakes on the hot plate
with the fry daddy on the nice things.
Talking about putting in the foodie, it's healthier.
If you hungry, I made some eggs.
And don't forget my Diet Coke.
Now, anyway, what you going to say about the running backs, Box?
This is what I want everybody to understand about the running back coach. If he leaves, so what? One thing Arkansas he never had to worry about was running backs.
True.
Period.
True.
I don't care how bad the quarterback was, how bad the defense was, how bad the offense was, we ain't never had to worry about a running back coach or running backs. So we will be okay. Yeah. Now, the only thing we will miss from him is some of the Georgia recruits, because since the NIL, that ain't that big a deal either, because money talks.
Facts.
Yeah.
So I don't think we're going to be missing at all. Plus, we're getting a dude from the NFL. And the last time I checked, the Miami Dolphin running backs was fired last year.
Why he get fired, though?
He probably didn't get fired. Did he get fired?
Or the Miami Dolphins coach, he got fired.
That's cool. I mean, Saban got fired when he was Dolphins too. So being fired in the NFL don't mean nothing.
It means something.
It don't mean nothing. That means you just ain't good enough for the NFL, but you're great for college.
What? Oh man, you know what? It doesn't necessarily mean you're not good enough. It may mean that, you know what, somebody just don't, that y'all may. It's the same in the NFL. I mean, the dynamics are still the same. If you don't like somebody, don't like what you say, done, whatever. You know what? I don't like you no more, Box. You got to get out of here. So it's year to year. I mean, all those contracts in the NFL are year to year. That's what people don't understand.
Hey, did nobody say why the Miami Dolphins defense coordinator? Left. I mean, he was the best thing on the team last year. The defense.
Where you go?
He left.
Where you go?
He went to Philadelphia Eagles.
Oh, so he got another job, paying more money.
He left.
Hey, shout out to William Richards, man. Flex on him. He said, man, it's been a while.
Oh, it's been a while, fellas. Man.
We ain't seen you in here, Bill Dix. We ain't seen you Bill in a while. Dix. Hey, man, appreciate you supporting the channel, man. We appreciate you. Can't wait for football season to kick back in, man. We going to really be in here.
Yes, sir.
I got two things that I'm wondering.
Go ahead, DZ.
The two things you good I wonder, now. And it's on this whole Jimmy thing, man. Is one,
Jimmy got Jimmy.
Who
got,
leave
Jimmy
with him?
Soul.
Who leaves with Jimmy? And then two, who does Bobby bring in to replace him?
They already got a person, and ain't nobody leaving.
They got a coach, but are you asking what players leave?
No. What? Hold on. They already replaced Jimmy.
Well, yeah. they already talking about it.
He comes.
That's what Boss was just talking about.
Yeah, he was talking about
he's a Bobby Petrino coach. He coached Bobby Petrino everywhere. He come by. If that's who Bobby want, he getting it. He was a GA at Arkansas. He followed Bobby almost every stop until he went to Miami Dolphins.
Not another grad assistant. Oh, my God.
He was a grad assistant at Arkansas, bro.
I'm sick of these.
When Bobby Petrino was that in. That's a long time ago.
Have he did anything since being a grad assistant, or he still just been a grad assistant?
How many thousand yard rush we had last? How many thousand yard rush we had last year, Deason?
We had the worst O line in college football too.
Okay, but how many thousand yard rush we had last year?
Zero.
So what did Jimmy Smith do?
I mean, I give you that, but I'm not gonna act like I'm not a recency bias type of guy. I understand that bad times happen. Musselman having a terrible season, but he not a terrible coach. We had a terrible running back season last year, but I don't think Jimmy Smith is a terrible coach. If that's the case, he would have been a finalist for Georgia if he was bad.
But so, here's the deal, DZ. No one is saying that he's a bad coach. What I am saying, and I think that's what everybody else is saying, I ain't really tripping that he leaving. It ain't like I'm like, oh my God, we've lost the only thing, you know what I'm saying, that's going. That's all I'm saying. Yeah, he's a great coach, good coach. I ain't holding him on that, but I ain't mad that you leaving. If he would have got, think about this, if he would have gotten that job at Georgia, we would have been talking about it a little bit different. Man, I'm glad he upgrading himself. He doing this, he doing that. Man, let's see who we got next. So since he didn't get the, I mean, he got the job and Pittman blocked him, now he leaving. Now it's like, oh, man, now I ain't tripping because he leaving, period.
Hey, Deezy, let me ask you a question. How long has Jimmy Smith been there at Arkansas?
As long as Pittman been here.
How many players we got in NFL running backs?
Mm-mm. Boy, Box is shooting at you, man. You better put a shield up.
Hey, we're going to give him an 8 count for a minute.
Hey, I always got something back now. Hold on now. Hey,
we're going to get these 8 count while I read my super chat, man.
Box over here gave this dude the uppercut.
Hey, Box came in here. He got melatonin in his gloves tonight. Hey, man, shout out to Ty Collins, man. He said, everybody, let's wipe our feet real quick. Take a pause for a quick second and hit the like button. Subscribe.
Let's do it, man. Y'all help your boys out, man. We got 222 people in the room, man. We always like to get to that magical number, man, of 100 while we on the live stream. But, hey, like OD said, go tell a friend to tell a friend. Man, we trying to get to 3,000 subscribers before we hit our year anniversary. That's right, man. We only been doing this for 11 months, man. We about to hit a year, and we want to celebrate that with everybody at the game. We're going to celebrate that at the game, man, for a 1 year in the game. We're going to do that on August the 31st. Y'all remember that. We're going to be cooking. We're going to be kicking it. We're going to be doing a lot of stuff. Y'all come down here and kick it with us for the first game in football, Arkansas UAPB in Little Rock at War Memorial Stadium, going down. Like and subscribe.
Hey, man, my wife graduated from UAPB, man. She said they're going to win. She don't watch no football.
I mean, OD, I know you. Hey, you could tell she watched no football.
Hey, she said, I bet we win halftime, though.
They're going to win halftime.
No lie.
They're going to win halftime.
They're going to win halftime.
Bro, so 2 years ago when they were here, we was at the game, right? So we sitting on the home side, so the band is facing us as they're playing. So, you know, UAPB did their thing, and then Arkansas did their thing, and then they all came on to the field. One from the 50-yard line over was UAPB. The other 50 was, Arkansas, and they were playing the same song. Literally, bro, I was like, is Arkansas playing? They drowned them suckers out so much that you couldn't even hear them playing, and they on the same field, bro. It was bad, bro. I was like, oh, my God. And I'm looking like, do they got some special horns over here at UAPB? Because I don't know what I'm telling you, bro. If you was at that game, I would have been embarrassed as an Arkansas Razorback band member if you go back and watch that tape. You need to be doing breathing exercises and learn how to get some better breath. Because them bros down there at UAPB, hey, they different with it. They different with it, man. It was just unbelievable that they was even on the same field together. I was like, man, this is terrible.
You know why? you know why I wasn't surprised about the band? Because HBCUs got the best bands around.
Facts.
Yeah, that's facts.
Since day one. Yeah.
That's facts.
They band bigger than their football team.
That's true too.
Anyway.
Hey, but while he playing, I know John Neighbor's probably like, they're way too loud over there.
Why is this band playing so loud? I can't even hear you, Margaret.
I don't know any of these songs. What are these songs?
What? Is that Michael Jackson that they're playing? Oh my God. I can't hear you.
Hey man.
Get out of here.
We got a Deezy supporter in the building, man. He's shooting shots at G Holmes, man. He said,
what up?
Man, y'all need to hear Deezy, man. G Holmes seemed like everybody we lose, somebody they would trash. Deezy, point is that we had some great people. What would you say when Bobby leave in the middle of the night? Hey, shots fired at
no.
G.
Hold on.
Yeah, he shot fire. Hey, y'all shoot at the boy with Matthew 6:33 and 34, man. He hit you with it, man.
Hey, man.
Hold on. Hey, wait.
Y'all knocked me out, and then they hopped in over my body like, nah, y'all ain't going to do that.
Hey, DZ, the only reason they did that, because that was such a great uppercut. You feel like Francis. Hey, you feel like Francis yesterday.
Yeah, this well. Why y'all okay. don't got to. Don't give Box no juice. He don't need no juice.
So listen here, man. I let me respond to that. It says G Holmes seems like every time we lose somebody, they were trash. That ain't what I'm saying, bro. I'm not saying that. I never said that Jimmy Smith was a bad coach. That I just explained that. I'm not saying that he was trash. I said that if he leaves, I'm okay with it. What did we truly lose? Yes, we did lose a great recruiter, but fundamentally wise, how were our running backs last year? I just talked about some of the fundamentals that they missed, pass blocking. I mean, it was terrible. We watched a game where DePinion missed several blocks and caused big losses for sacks. Whether he did that on purpose, it almost seemed like it had to be on purpose because it was that bad of a whiff. But I'm not saying that the coach is trash. So, don't put that on me. I'm not acting like that. I'm just saying, you know what? If he left, I ain't tripping. Because guess what? Like Box has said, like OD has said, we ain't never had no problem getting a running back.
Yeah, that's true. One thing the Razorbacks can't do is run the rock. Hey,
put that super chat up, because that's facts right there.
So, Jeremiah, man, flex on him. He said, why us as Hall fans got to keep accepting moral victories? We got to stop accepting mediocrity as the norm. We will never elevate as a program in any sport with this mediocrity mentality. Winning should be the norm, not losing.
Bro, that's what you said.
Hey, man. We down there with Vanderbilt right now, both sports.
We below them because they beat us this year.
Dang, man.
Bro, I mean, is this the worst sports year of the last 20 years? I think it was.
Yeah, it's just it's just been a bad year for Razorback, the big Razorback sports, I'll say that. It's basketball and football.
Yeah, it's been bad.
Hey, let me say this right here. And while we talking about fine people, go ahead and fire the Arkansas women basketball coach. He's been doing the same thing for years.
It don't matter. Go ahead and fire him too. Play anyway.
They start out good though.
Yeah, go ahead and fire. Yeah, because everybody know we start out. We always start out good, but get trashed late on this season.
Yeah, they were balling the first of the year.
Shout out to my guy Sam Mbaki on Twitter. He kicking it with us tonight, man. Shout him out.
What up, Mbaki?
We gonna see him back in the SEC, man, doing big things, man.
Yeah, come home, dog.
Yeah, we need you, dog. We need you, dog.
You want me to tell you why he ain't gonna come home? You want me to tell you why he won't come back to Arkansas? Because they got too much pride to bring him back.
Hey, we brought Bobby back. Hey, I think all that pride gone.
They bought Bobby back because Bobby is the offense coordinator. He ain't a player. That's the difference. Mm. You ain't seen no former player that left Arkansas and came back to Arkansas, but you don't seen coaches come back.
Hold on.
I finna say,
the receiver just did it.
Who?
Stevens.
He didn't leave. He just went in the portal.
Man, that's
he didn't leave. Hey, he didn't get kicked off the team.
Let me ask you a question, Box. If your girl say, hey, look here, I'm leaving, and she pack a bag, you gonna let her come back home?
Hey, there's plenty of players in college get in the portal and get out the portal and stay at their school.
Box don't like answering the question, man. Box.
That's what I'm saying. Your question is, that ain't the same.
She packed the bag. I'm gone. Box, I ain't got nowhere to go. Can I come back home?
If she stay gone a couple hours, yes. But if you stay gone more than one day, no. Yeah, that's plenty of time for you to open up your legs to somebody else. Stay out there. Oh, but a couple hours, I could deal. Hey, a couple hours, I could deal with that. Ain't no damage been done. But a day, man, you can do a lot of damage in a day. So stay gone.
No, another one. Jimmy Witt. That's another one. Right there. There go another one. Jimmy Witt.
That's a different circumstance. He didn't get kicked off the team. Sam got kicked off the team. You ain't seen no player got kicked off the team at no school that allowed to come back. Now you leaving on your own is different than getting kicked off the team.
Hey, why y'all get him started, man? Why y'all do it?
Y'all know Box from the gutter, man. He gonna keep it.
Well,
wait a minute. Hey, Greg, change that. I ain't from the gutter. I'm not from Southwest. Don't put that on me.
Well, I'm gonna say the mentally wise.
He said you got Southwest tendencies.
You got Southwest tendencies.
Well, I see a lot of people in the chat say out a long time, but it's a lot you got to do in an hour. You got to drive. You got to get gas. You got to get food. That's taking about an hour, so I can deal with an hour. But anything over that, you gone. And so an hour ain't that long when you really think about it, because you got to drive somewhere. You got to drive back. You got to get gas. You got to get food. Yeah, and a lot of damage been done an hour. But somebody can do a whole bunch of damage in 3 hours. Hey,
Smokey said he needs 3.5 minutes, maybe 4. What you mean? What you mean?
Maybe.
Mr. Potter, hey, what
they
doing.
Say? Hey. Hey, a heavyweight boxing round. In 3 minutes, it's been people knocked out in the first round.
Hey, I was on my side until the women start coming. When they said an hour ain't that long, I'm scared now. How long? What I need to know?
Hey, if Baki say I'm going to be worth too much, baby, I got sacrificed. Ooh. If you eat, it was either me or them. If you know, you know.
Hey, I like him. I like him. I don't want him to come back. I want him to go somewhere else and shine.
Hey.
Because he didn't do nothing to leave.
Nah, I'm following this. I'm following Ibaka. Ibaka going to be on the next level, man. He going to be on the NFL.
Yeah.
I'm following him.
Hey, remember us, man, whenever you make it, bro. We always rep for you and we ride with you, man. So you always can come back and holler at your boys, man, whenever. Let us know, man, when you ready to do another interview, bro. We got you.
Hey, Nisha says, some of y'all men only need 2 minutes. 2 minutes of riding high to teach you.
I don't know if this wrong or not, but Nisha, if I ain't had none in a couple of weeks, it's gonna be one minute. Just be prepared.
Mr. Touch and Bust.
that don't mean I'm a bad man. That don't mean I'm a bad in bed. That mean I just ain't had none in a while.
Mr. Touch and Bust, man.
Hey, man, y'all leave. But y'all stop. Boy, don't get Box riled up, man. Y'all
stop. Okay. Box, you got a new nickname, Mr. Touch and Bust, baby.
That's what Shannon Sharp said.
Let's call it Mr. Touch and Bust.
Oh, my God. I'm about to start crying, man.
Hey, somebody in the comments says 60 seconds Box.
Oh, man, y'all God, crazy, bro. Man.
Hey, if you don't want me to do it in 2 minutes, give me some on a regular. Hey, I can do that.
I dare anybody to tell me another Razorback podcast that's funnier than this one right here.
Bro.
Hey, Boss Hog said quick Box.
you can talk about me all you want. Cause if I'm busting 2 minutes, it's your fault, not mine.
Mr. Touch and Bust, man.
Hey, if it wasn't so good, I would take an hour. So be happy I'm doing it 2 minutes.
Man, y'all literally got me crying up in this jump, bro. Oh, my God, this is funny.
my God. Oh, my God. Oh, Mr. Touch and Bust in the building, baby.
My dude, bro, that was funny.
God. Hey, hey, Shannon Sharp said, man, if she got that ooh wee, what you want me to do? What you want me to do?
Oh my God.
Ooh, oh my God. Man, I got a super chat, man. We need a break, man. Oh my God, oh, man. This is hilarious, man. Hold on, man. Hold on, hold on.
That shoe shop was super chat.
Oh my God, bro.
Man, I'm in this mud laughing and sweating. I don't know if it's the jokes or if it's this Grand Marnier. Hey.
I got it.
Hey, let me tell y'all something. Francis Ngannou, whatever his name is, he took 8 weeks to train and got knocked out in six minutes. So don't talk to me about 2 minutes. I ain't trained for that.
Oh my God,
man, bruh, you do this funny.
I
this
promise
is,
you.
Them hey, man, gone in 60 seconds. Starting box.
I mean, hey, bro, you know what? What the funny thing is, man? I don't even know how we got here. I don't even know how we got to what happened in the barbershop. How did we get
the barbershop, man?
Oh my God, how did we even get here?
Mama Armstrong in the building. She don't like that 60-second box.
Hey, Mama, hey, wait a minute. Wait a minute. I can last 30 minutes.
Andrew, log off. Andrew, log off.
Oh my God, man. I don't care what nobody say, man. Y'all is hilarious.
This the WuPig Podcast After Dark, man.
Oh my gosh.
Oh man.
Okay, all right. We gotta get back on task, man.
Oh. Oh my God, man. I am crying. I need a towel.
Ooh. Hey, man, that's the show, man. It's a wrap. Hey, D2G, take us out of here, man.
Oh, man.
Oh, my God. Dude, this is too funny, man. I got a headache.
Anyways, how about them hogs? You know what I'm saying?
They losing like boxing 60 seconds.
Hey, OD, I'm going to bed smiling and happy. Hey, you can be mad all you want. I'm happy and I'm sleeping good.
Boy, Mr. Touch and Bust, baby, I got mine. You better get yours.
Better get yours. Y'all is funny tonight, man. Y'all been funny tonight, bro.
Man, Larissa said, put the women and the kids to bed, man. It's the whole pig after dark, man. Oh my gosh, bro! This been a great show, man. This been a great. We ain't got nothing else to talk about, man. We done went off the rails for the last 10 minutes, man. Hey, if you ain't done so, man, we got 250 people in the building, man. Make sure you hit the like button, man, for the YouTube algorithm. If you haven't subscribed, make sure you subscribe to the channel. We appreciate everybody who has super chats, man. We appreciate you guys for supporting the channel, man. It's been a great show. As always, I say that every time, but I tell you, it gets better and better every episode, man. Deezy, what you got to say to us, man?
Hey, man. First, I just want to say y'all got some problems, bro. Y'all is crazy. I don't know what's wrong with us. Hey,
wait a minute.
I'm the young
Deezy.
One.
Hey, Deezy, before you get
I'm
bro,
innocent.
Bro, we ain't 22 no more.
I am.
Wait a minute. You got a mouse in your pocket. Don't put me in your business.
Talk about some
wee.
Hey, but yeah, man, I just want to say shout out to the people supporting us, man. Shout out to these crazy dudes I get to share this platform with. Hey, it was another great one, man. And for the record, for the people that didn't know, because I didn't know, Kobe Smith is the name of the guy that's supposed to be replacing Jimmy Smith. So, you know, do your research. Kobe Smith with a K. I'll give y'all a little rundown on the next episode if he get hired.
Box, Mr. Touch and Buzz, you got anything to say? Hey.
Touch and Buzz, what you got?
Hey, I'm good. I finna go work on my stamina.
Oh my God. Hey, unbiased in the closet said, speak for yourself. Hey, G, take us out of here.
Yo, 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 it's your boy, man. It's your boy G Holmes in the building, man. AKA Big Sexy.
Oh, oh, oh my God.
Man, it's been another wonderful show. Man, thanks everybody for coming in here, kicking it in the barbershop with us, man. This is what you get when you come to the WuPig Podcast. You never know where it's gonna go. But I'm telling you, like, subscribe, man. Help us get to those milestones of 3,000 views. But before you do anything else, you know what we want you to do? Man, we want you to experience peace of mind with Insurance Max. They're your one-stop shop for home, auto, and commercial insurance. We're talking about statewide, all over Arkansas. So don't wait. You call today for a free, no-obligation quote and secure your future with Insurance Max. It's where protection meets affordability. You give Caleb and Wes a call and safeguard what matters to you the most. 870-534-2823. Again, that's 870-534-2823. And again, we always got to give a shout out to the OGs, 3M Electric. They are your trusted electrical contractor serving Northwest Arkansas. They do both commercial and electrical contracting. They are an SDVOSB. That's a service disabled veteran-owned small business. These guys are dependable and reliable, with no job being too big or too small. So guess what? For all your electrical needs, give the guys over there at 3M Electrical call. That number is 479-408-9865. Again, that number is 479-408-9865. And give them let them know that the WuPig Podcast sent you. So look here, man.
Get that super chat for me.
Yeah, get the super chat.
Go ahead and take it out.
Yo, the super chat says, how much y'all going to cost to keep y'all going for another hour? Hey, man. Bro, we appreciate you, bro. We really do, man. We appreciate you rocking with us, man. That's what we like. We like people to enjoy coming. That way, it builds up some anticipation for the next show, because we're going to keep giving it to you raw like this. But look here. Remember, write these dates down on your calendars, WuPig family. April the 13th, we're going to be up on the hill. We're going to come up there. We'll be up there Friday night and Saturday night. I think we're going to try to get something together on Friday. I think we might try to go out to the catfish hole. So we're going to go have a meet and greet out there, man, drink some beer and just kick it for a little bit Friday night. We're trying to firm up that stuff. So just stay tuned. But that's what we're looking at, is going out to the catfish hole off of Weddington. Also, August the 31st, right here in Little Rock, Arkansas, at the War Memorial Stadium, the WuPig Podcast will be there live and in the flesh, and we're going to be kicking it like we're kicking it right now. We're inviting everybody. Bring your friends, your family. Bring everybody out there, man, because we're going to be kicking it, man, and we're going to be cooking, and we're just going to have a good time, man. It's just a family atmosphere, and we just want to extend that invitation to everybody, because you are our family. And we real dudes, man. We like to kick it. We have a good time. We jone each other. We talk about each other. But it's all love for you guys, and it's all love for the Hogs. So at the end of the day, baby, you already know what Big Sexy like to say. I said what I said, and we out.
Oh my God.
Yeah, it's the 501, baby.
Uh-huh.
You know how we get down on the WuPig Podcast.
Woo.
Shout out OD, shout out G Holmes, it's the
Big Sexy.